Let's have a sit down and let's, you know, handle this mental health situation. Also, let's try to, you know, groom you so that way you can handle business appropriately, especially with all the gang whack out tats on his face. You know what I'm saying? Like, anything can happen to him, and it's just going to be another sad story. Oh, damn. You know, hey, this bro, man is, you know.
Hey, bro, you do know that when you say exploited, you do know why they want to talk to Crip Mac, right? You understand they see him. Let me tell you how they see him, bro. And I'm going to be real, because I watch the nigga all the time. I watch the nigga to laugh. Fuck all the shit he's saying. He can say cuz 7 million times. I watch Crip Mac to be entertained, right? Bro, what's that little nigga? Snacks and that other little nigga? The little nigga, like, I don't know if he kind of like mentally retarded or something. Y'all know what I'm talking about? Snacks, it was two of them. They were like a little duel. Bro, that's why they interview Crip Mac. Because of how he talk, his mannerisms, that's his flow into the industry, bro. Let's just be real. Like, so, you know, they want to talk to him. They want to listen to him talk, how he talk, the way he talk, the words that he creates. You know, like that, bro, that's what that shit is, bro. Like, sometimes you got to see it for what it is, not for what we want it to be. Like, why do we watch Crip Mac? We watch him for his music. We want to hear what this nigga gonna say and how he gonna say it. His words, undefined me, sitches, this, like, nigga, and it's comical, it's funny. Like, this shit's entertaining.
It's definitely entertaining, and it's expression of the culture. But when they was talking about the exploitation, they was saying, does he really have a business team? Does he have a manager that's doing these bullshit?
No, he don't. But see, him going on all these shows is what got y'all even saying that. That nigga was just another nigga over there on the motherfucking block. You know what I'm saying? He started YouTubing, doing his little shit. Now, next thing you know, fucking Adam 22 wanna interview the nigga. These niggas want to interview the nigga. I don't call it exploited. I think he a rapper. I haven't heard none of his music.
Yeah. He got a single.
Yeah, I don't know if his music is worth it. I don't want to hear. I ain't gonna say that though. I just want to see the nigga. You know, like, I like to hear the nigga talk on some real shit. Like, and I'm a blood. This nigga be Crip the fuck out, but I don't give a fuck. Because the nigga's entertaining to me. I like to hear the nigga talk. You know what I'm saying? On some real shit. But, you know, whatever they've been doing, it's been helping him, you know, get in front of that light that, you know, he need to be in front of, bro. You know what I mean? So, you know, the nigga, he doing this shit. I think he just freelancing. I don't think he know where this shit was going. It's just going somewhere.
And that's really basically what I'm saying. It's like, you know, it sucks for you to be an individual to run into the opportunity to where, so now you're making the money, but you don't have no sense of direction. You just basically freestyling. So when we saying exploiting, that's why we saying, like, where's his foundation at? Where's the people that's actually going to make sure he's good in the next 2 to 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 months?
But a nigga don't know what to do unless he going to do stand-up comedy, my nigga. Like, what is he doing? I'm saying? Let's fucking be real. Let's do stand-up comedy. Like, what the, like, you know, unless Tyler Perry gonna go put the nigga in a movie like he Brother Man from the Fifth Floor. Like, what? Like, they say, whack, take this dude. I'm gonna be like, okay, what? I'm gonna be like, yo, Nick Cannon, can I put this nigga on one of them niggas and Wildin' Out? Some shit. I don't know what to do with the nigga. I like to watch him talk his shit, but what do you do? Do you put him on the stage and let him be a comic, be a comedian? Some real shit. I ain't trying to be funny or nothing. Niggas like to watch him, like to hear his tone of voice and all that shit. So, fuck, how do you know where you go with that?
So you view him as like a comedian?
Nigga, I do not take that. I know he a Crip. I know he from 5-5 neighborhood and all that. But nigga, I do not take nothing he's saying derogatory or serious, nigga. That shit is fucking entertaining. That shit's entertaining to me, bro. Bro, under fight me, no fight, fight, crap, nigga. Like some bitches, I get imitated, nigga. I watch the shit out this nigga. Let's keep it real, bro. Am I the only nigga gonna keep it real? That niggas watch that nigga because he's entertaining?
No, I'm saying he is entertaining, but I'm gonna sit here and say I don't really see him as funny. I just be amazed by what he's doing. Like, people, you know what I'm saying? Like, what is he going to do next? I don't think he's funny. I just be, like, amazed. Like,
I look at the nigga that he's funny as a motherfucker. That nigga's entertaining, bro. I'm sorry.
So you saying his name is like Watts Homie Quan?
Nah, he got him beat because of his voice and his delivery and what, you know what I'm saying? I fuck with Watts Homie, but this nigga Crip Mac, that nigga, bro, it ain't a nigga running around talk like that nigga, bro. You know what I'm saying? That nigga got it. He say some words. That nigga educated me on all the new Crip words. I didn't even know them words existed. Nigga, I done heard some shit. But that nigga say, yeah, I went and got some stitches. I'm like, we rhyme that shit. What that nigga just say? You know what I'm saying? Like, he say some shit, and I just find it. I will watch that nigga.
But it's like, you think, like, he got the Popeye shit. He could probably get some kind of corporate sponsor with them, right?
What'd he do with Popeyes?
He always been promoting it.
No, right. He's just been promoting it, right?
Yeah,
I'm not sure. That was one of the questions. Like, does he have a corporate sponsorship with him? He always promoting them, right?
Yeah, well, bro, you got to understand this, too, bro. Like, y'all got to keep it real with y'allself. Right, everything about that nigga's face, his tattoos represent violence and gang culture, bro. The odds of that happening is slim to none. Now we talking,
and
business.
That's what we talking about now.
Now we talking business, bro. Like,
yeah, exactly. Like, that's what we were saying. Like
now you done entered management mode, nigga. Popeyes is gonna say, okay, you telling us you want us to exploit gang culture? He has a gang that says killer on his face, and you want us to do what with our
And that's what we saying. Like, he ain't gonna go too far. He gonna be a fly by night eventually.
So that's why the nigga should be a stand up comedy nigga. He won't be shit, nigga. That nigga could tour. That nigga, bro, they know who he is. Niggas know who he is. That's the number one thing that artists gotta get, is for people to know who the fuck they are, bro. They know who that nigga is, bro.
That nigga's a gimmick, man.
You know, shit. You not finna. Ain't nobody finna put that nigga on.
That nigga's a
whole gimmick. No Sprite something or no shit like that. That ain't gonna happen, bro.
And he utilizing something that motherfuckers is doing life and die behind as a gimmick and making that shit look clownish. He need to stop that shit. Somebody gonna clap
but
on that boy.
He ain't gonna stop it because I'm gonna tell you why he ain't gonna stop it. That attention, man. That attention. That attention. The fact that he can walk down the street right now and a motherfucking little Filipino kid know who he is. Like that shit. I'm telling you.
And you also, that's another thing.
You know,
like,
I'm going to tell you about attention. Tell you something about attention, man. The fattest pig always gets slaughtered.
Yeah, I know, but see, you're an older dude talking. I can hear you talking. So you're not going to understand what I'm saying, bro. I get it, because I'm in this game. I get it. That nigga got a neighborhood on his head whacked out to where he got too much attention. Don't get it fucked up.
Ain't no different than 6ix9ine.
Right.
That nigga's going to smoke that 6ix9ine boy. Ain't got no neighborhood
crossed out on
his head. Yeah, we
not
going
to add 6ix9ine
to this. Nah. He ain't got no neighborhood crossed out on his head.
I'm talking about marketing.
Like,
he could market like 6ix9ine marketed with some thorough shit, though.
Nah, listen, bro. I mean, you know, it's a gift and a curse with him, because it's a lot of hoovers that probably didn't know who the fuck he was. They know who he is now.
Absolutely. Oh, yeah.
Right. And you understand what I'm saying? They ain't going to play with it, my nigga. That's why he ain't in California. Dude, don't live in California like that. Don't think he running around like, shit, boy, what?
He ain't gonna make it, man.
Lamonte, this is what I was talking about earlier. Lamonte, you heard? Like, boy, he only got a certain amount of time. I'm telling you.
They gonna knock his noodle. We all know that. That's why. That's what I'm saying. Like, he, bro, like, Let's just be real, my nigga. Like, he ride away.
Hey, Wack, we trying to keep his Campbell soup within the cans. That's why we. That's why this discussion is being had. You know what I'm saying?
He brought too much attention to it. So with that on him, that ain't going to happen.